Hello, I'm Advocate Nikita Pandit, and I will be speaking on the infringement of patent rights and remedies, and you're watching Legal Bites. The main objective of this video is to understand what constitutes violation of the patent rights of an inventor and when he can approach the courts and for what reliefs. We have already seen what a patent is, how the registration of patent is done, and which rights it gives to the patent holder. Section 48 of the Patents Act of 1970 gives certain rights to the patent holder with respect to his invention. This section gives exclusive right to the patent holder to use, sell, offer for sale, or distribute the product or the process of service which is the subject matter of the patent. He can prevent any other person or an entity from doing such acts which he can do without his permission. The authorized use by any person is when a person has been assigned the patent rights by the patent holder. Assignment is the legal transfer to another person of the rights or the property for a consideration. Patents, being transferable rights, can be assigned to another person. Section 68 of the Act clearly specifies that assignment agreement must be in writing, and such document should also specify the rights and liabilities of the parties clearly. The same is the case of licenses. License in basic language means allowing or permitting anyone to do a particular act. This means during that license period, the acts as that of the patent holder, in this case, can be done without his permission by the licensee. In this case too, Section 68 provides that the license must be in writing. After putting it in writing, the same document must be submitted to the controller for entering his name in the register. If the proof of rightful title is given, the controller is bound to enter the name as the title proprietor or the co-proprietor. And if any interest is created by any instrument, such particulars are also to be entered in the register. In case of the dispute to the title, the controller has the right to refuse entering such particulars in the register till the court decides the title. In case of license and assignment, it is a must to provide the copies of the agreements, licenses, and all such documents which are necessary and which are associated with the title of that person with respect to the patent. Section 83 puts some common principles to remember when using the patented inventions. The main reason for giving the patent rights is to encourage the inventions and to make sure that the same are used in India commercially. They must be reasonable, that is, fairly and affordably used in India without any delay. It is not just for the sake of monopoly so that one person or an entity can use it. Monopoly is where the entire supply will be in the hands of one person, and this would cause severe arbitrary use by that person or an entity, and it would hamper the benefit of the society. Patents promote the scientific and technological advancement in the society so that there is benefit to the producers on one hand, and there is social, economic, and technological development of the society on the other hand. Such patent rights should be such that it does not put any limitation on the trading activities or affect the transfer of technology internationally. Such invention should be reasonably affordable to the public. It should not have exorbitant prices that public cannot purchase it. If at all the reasonable requirement of the public are not satisfied, or if it is not given for reasonably affordable prices, or if it is not given to be used in India, then after 3 years of grant of patent, any person can apply to the controller to grant them the compulsory license to do all such acts which are not done by the patent holder. The controller sees if the applicant is capable of doing such acts, what is the nature of invention, the capital risk and working of invention, and whether the applicant can bear the same. It is also seen if the applicant approached the patent holder to give him the license and there was failure in that. The only exceptions are national emergency, extreme urgency, public non-commercial use, or anti-competitive practices, and this all should be before the application date. When any unauthorized acts are made of the patented invention by any person, such as doing the acts which are contained in the patent rights without the license or an assignment. It amounts to infringement. Infringement means violation of the law or hampering with another person's rights. The Patents Act of 1970 also provides for the remedies against the infringement. The jurisdiction for instituting the infringement suit is the district court, in the same sense as given in the Civil Procedure Code of 1908, and this is given in Section 2E of the Act. In case of revocation of patents, the jurisdiction is the High Court. In case of infringement, the reliefs that can be obtained as per Section 108 are injunction, temporary or permanent as the case may be, wherein the court orders doing or refraining from doing such infringement, and the relief of either damages, that is compensation against the loss, or the accounts of profit. Accounts of profit can be said to be the profits that the person has made when he breached the duty, that is, that he had lawfully had to follow. The court can also order the infringed material to be confiscated, destroyed, or forfeited if it feels so. Section 111 provides for the exceptions against such actions if the defendant proves that he was not reasonably aware that the patent he was apparently infringing was registered. As per Section 104A, in case of the process where the product is obtained, or if there is a possibility that the identical products made by any other person is by that process, but the patentee is not able to determine if actually the person has used his process, but he shows that the product achieved is identical to his, the court may order the evidence to be proved by the defendant that the process that he has used to get those products is different from the one patented. Any person under Section 105 can institute a suit in the court if he wants to seek a declaration that the acts that he is doing is not an infringement of patent rights of the patentee. And if at all it is proved that such person has given an application in writing to the patent holder or his exclusive licensee for acknowledgement in writing that all the details of the claims of the process of the article are given to him, and such patentee or licensee refuses to give the acknowledgement or neglects to do so, the declaration suit can also be made after the grant of patent, which is published by the controller. It can only be done after the publication. The Act also provides the protection in case a person is threatened by someone who is interested in such patent rights orally or in writing or in any other manner that they would institute the legal proceedings against them. Then such case, the former one can go to the court for obtaining the declaration that such threats are not justifiable or reasonable and get an injunction to stop them immediately under Section 106. Damages can be claimed if any loss is suffered by such person due to the threats. Until the threatening person proves that what he did was because the plaintiff's act would lead to infringement, and if such claims by the plaintiff are not invalid, the court can grant him the declaration. Section 107 and 107A constitute the defenses to the suit of infringement. Section 107 mentions that whatever constitutes the grounds for revocation of patent can also be used as defenses in case of infringement. Such grounds are given in Section 64 of the Act, such as the earlier claim in the specification by another person having previous priority date, that is, the patent did not fulfill the compliances of the Act, that the patent rights received by him were in contravention of the person using such defense, that the subject matter is not an invention itself, that the invention is previously known or published as per the Act, that the invention is not useful, that the complete specification is not sufficient, or it does not mention the method or a process or the best way of obtaining the results, that claims are not clearly mentioned, that it gives false representation or suggestion, that such invention was secretly used in India before the priority date, that no information or false information regarding foreign applications is given to the controller, that the permission to make the amendments to complete specification was received by fraud. It is also a defense that such acts are within the meaning of Section 47 of the Act. The acts were done by the government or on its behalf or for its own use, or if published in the official gazette, or if the acts are done for experimenting or doing research or for education. The tribunal's reforms, rationalization and conditions of service ordinance 2021 abolished the appellate board under the act as well as under the trademarks act of 1999. So the appeal from the controller rises in the high court, which is to be made within 3 months from the date of such decision as per section 116. Chapter 20 provides for the penalties under the act. Some of the important ones to remember are section 119, which gives up to 2 years imprisonment or fine or both if one makes or causes to be made any false entry in the register of patents. As per section 120, if any person falsely shows that what he is offering is a patented product or is applied for the same in India by mentioning or implying that the patent lies in it, maybe stamping or engraving or impressing, then the punishment is fine up to rupees 1 lakh. As per section 122, if any person fails to provide the information to the central government or controller for the purpose of this act, then the penalty is up to 10 lakh rupees. And if the provided information is false, then the imprisonment is up to 6 months or fine or both. As per section 124, in case of companies, the company as well as the person in charge is held liable for infringement if proved. And if such person wants to get released, he has to prove that he genuinely had no knowledge of such infringing acts or he had done due diligence on his part.